गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबडी. आई विल बी प्रेजेंटिंग माई ओरल पेपर प्रेजेंटेशन ऑन द टॉपिक रोल ऑफ मल्टी डिटेक्टर कॉम्पिटेटिव टोमोग्राफी इन द इवैल्यूएशन ऑफ नेक मासेस एंड देयर हिस्टोपैथोलॉजिकल एसोसिएशन. नेक इज अ कॉनिकल स्पेस एक्सटेंडिंग फ्रॉम द बेस ऑफ स्कल टू द थोरैक्सिक इनलेट. द पेशेंट विद पैथोलॉजी ऑफ नेक मासेस यूजुअली प्रेजेंट विद द हिस्ट्री ऑफ नेक स्वेलिंग, पेन, हॉर्सनेस ऑफ वॉइस, डिस्फेशिया, डिस्निया, फीवर, एक्सेट्रा. They can also have significant weight loss or loss of appetite, which favors malignant etiology or tubercular etiology. Neck masses can be classified as congenital and acquired. Congenital masses are present since birth, like thyroglossal cyst, brachial cyst, cystic hygroma. Acquired masses are further classified as nodal and extranodal in origin. Nodal masses can be inflammatory, reactive, infectious, and neoplastic. Common causes of nodal masses are tubercular lymphadenopathy, lymphoma, metastatic lymphadenopathy. Computed tomography is a very important diagnostic imaging modality for those patients in whom head and neck mass is suspect or evident. Improvement in image contrast comes by using 2D images, which shows a section of patient without the effect of overlap structures. Not only the early detection and characterization of masses, MDCT is also useful in follow-up of the patient. So the aim and objective of our study is to study the role of multi-detector computed tomography in the evaluation of neck masses and to study the spectrum of neck masses and correlating them with histopathological findings. This is a cross-sectional observation study done in our hospital from 1st July 2020 to 31st August 2021 at Department of Radio Diagnosis, Atal Bihari Vajpayee Institute of Medical Science and Dr. RML Hospital. 50 patients were taken who were presented with neck masses to our department. Pregnant ladies, patient having allergy to contrast media, and patient with deranged KFT were not taken for this study. We were able to trace the histopathological report of 45 patients and we correlated it with our findings. Most of the patients were in our study were less than 20 years of age, followed by the age group 41 to 50 years. Male were 62% and females were 38%. These are the clinical findings of the patient with which the patients were presenting for us for the CT. Neck swelling and pain was the most common clinical complaint, followed by fever. We further divided the masses as nodal and extranodal. In nodal, we were having 38%. In extranodal, we were having 31%. Out of 50 cases, 19 were nodal masses and 31 were extranodal masses. In nodal masses, 9 cases were of tubercular etiology, 3 were of lymphoma, 7 cases were of metastatic lymphadenopathy from various head and neck cancers. In extranodal masses, we further have category of congenital and acquired neck masses. In congenital neck masses, we found each cases of cystic hygroma, thyroglossal cyst, and congenital vascular malformation. In inflammatory non-neoplastic neck masses, we observed 2 cases of abscesses and 1 case of Ludwig's angina, 1 of saladinitis. In non-inflammatory neoplastic neck masses, we have studied 2 cases of ranula, 1 case of colloid nodule, and 1 case of vascular malformation. In benign neck masses, we found 1 case of lipoma, 4 cases of salivary tumor, that is pleomorphic adenoma, 1 case of vascular tumor, and 1 case of nerve sheath tumor, which is schwannoma in our case. In malignant neck masses, we have studied 6 cases of laryngeal carcinoma, 3 cases of thyroid carcinoma, 2 cases of tonsillar carcinoma, and 1 case of salivary gland carcinoma. There was a perfect agreement between the 2 methods, and this agreement was statistically significant. The sensitivity was 100% with specificity of 90% and positive predictive value of 93% and negative predictive value of 100% with diagnostic accuracy of 96%. 2 cases classified as benign by histopathological impression were classified as malignant by radiological impression. So neck masses can be nodal or extranodal in origin. They can be congenital or acquired and can further be divided as inflammatory and non-inflammatory, benign or malignant. Multi-detector computed tomography along with contrast study is a good imaging modality in characterization of neck masses. With the help of multiplanar reformats, detection of and telling the extension of neck masses on MDCT has become easier. MDCT is good for delineating osseous anatomy in comparison to any other modality. Moreover, it is cheap and readily available. Now, I will be discussing these cases which I have found in my study. These are the known, the first row will be of non-contrast images, followed by contrast in axial, sagittal, and coronal reformates. In my first case, 66-year-old male presented with neck swelling and hoarseness of voice. On CECT multiplanar reformates, we found that there was a there is a ill-defined heterogeneously enhancing soft tissue lesion involving glottis and supraglottic region with mild extension to subglottic region was seen. It was associated with cervical lymphadenopathy and diagnosis was squamous cell carcinoma. On histopathology and in CECT, we gave the diagnosis of transglottic carcinoma larynx. Next case, 55-year-old female presented with painful swelling in the left parotid space. On ultrasound, a well-defined mass lesion noted in the left parotid gland with increased vascularity. On CECT, we can see that there is a multilobulated heterogeneously enhancing mass in the superficial lobe of left parotid gland with few non-enhancing areas depicting necrosis. The diagnosis of sinus cell carcinoma was made on CECT and it was same on histopathology. 19-year-old female presented with the neck masses with a neck mass which moves with deglutition and protrusion of tongue. A cystic lesion is noted entrapped in the strap muscle, which was non-enhancing. So the diagnosis of thyroglossal cyst was made. In the next, you can see this in here. In the next case, 28-year-old male presented with pulsatile neck swelling. On ultrasound, a heteroechoic mass was noted upading the common carotid artery with minimal internal vascularity. On CECT, a heterogeneous enhancing mass was noted in infrahyoid left carotid space, which was causing splaying of internal common carotid artery and internal jugular vein, and it is causing pressure effect on left lobe of thyroid gland. The diagnosis was made schwannoma, which was confirmed by histopathology. 18-year-old male presented with bilateral neck swelling with low-grade fever. On ultrasound, necrotic cervical lymphadenopathy was seen. On CECT, multiple peripherally enhancing lymph nodes were seen at level 1B, 2, 3 cervical levels. So the diagnosis was given to tubercular lymphadenopathy and on histopathology, same diagnosis was confirmed. 66-year-old female presented with right-sided neck swelling. Ultrasound was showing soft flow of vascular malformation. On CECT, a mild peripherally enhancing lesion with specks of calcification was noted in the right side of the neck, as seen in this image. So the diagnosis of lymphovascular malformation was made. Next case, a 34-year-old female presented with right submandibular gland swelling. On ultrasound, a cystic mass noted in the concerned area. On CECT, cystic lesion in right submandibular gland extending to the floor of mouth was seen. So radiological diagnosis of plunging ranula was made. Coming to my last case, a 17-year-old female presented with right-sided neck swelling. On ultrasound, multilobulated cystic lesion was noted in the right side of cervical region extending posteriorly. On CECT, a well-defined cystic mass with mildly enhancing septa was noted in subcutaneous layer of right side of cervical region with its extension into the posterior aspect of the neck. Radiological diagnosis of cystic hygroma was made. Now coming to the conclusion, multi-detector computed tomography is a good modality in characterization of neck masses and further helps in the management of the patient. But the gold standard always will be the histopathological diagnosis. These are my references. Thank you.